So somebody asked me, what is my philosophical method? What is my basis for perception? And it's very difficult to understand precisely how I'm supposed to answer that question, because in some ways it's very broad and in quite a few ways it's a little bit hard to know what exactly the question may be probing for. But I will try. I'll make this preliminary video as a preliminary one, and I'll try to generally talk about philosophical methodology and address maybe one or two of the other questions that were posed in the same breath. So, my philosophical methodology, well, it is weird. It's very weird. One of the things that one can find in studying the difference between a Nietzschean approach to philosophy and a more conventional or systematic one is that what the Nietzschean approach handles is historical rupture. It's a circumstance of change from one way of perceiving and doing and believing to another way. So if we consider Nietzsche, he was at the cusp of a change of some considerable significance, whereby there was a movement toward a scientific methodology and away from religious belief. And I think he was pretty much at the crisis point of that, where things were significantly changing. And thus, the theme of the death of God was very pronounced in Nietzsche's writing, and the reason being that he was having to deal with the very fundamental change in foundation between the old way of looking at things and the new way. He was between, in that sense, tradition and modernity, and coming to terms with that. So we can see in the Nietzschean style of philosophizing, there is a crisis that has to be handled. And what is also very interesting in studying the academic literature is that shamans or shamans also appear at a time of crisis to interpret that situation to their community and help smooth the way along and make the adjustment easier, less calamitous. So, my methodology has also to do with being thrown into the situation of crisis, and indeed in my situation as well, historical crisis. And similar to Nietzsche, I found myself in a state of mind where I had a very religious outlook on things and a very moral outlook, and I believed in nobility, hierarchy, civilization, the strict division of gender roles, because I was brought up with that. I had all these old-fashioned and outdated positions on things, and not just that they were somehow a position that I embraced, but it had those had been inculcated into me through growing up and social and cultural conditioning. So I was very much of the old world, and my reference points were also old worldish, and my expectations for behavior were the same, and how I conducted myself was in line with these ideas of moral and spiritual rectitude and propriety. So when I encountered modernity, it was a constant shock to the system because people didn't do what I was doing, didn't understand what I was doing, and moreover, viewed me with a considerable amount of hostility because they saw me as belonging to an order or system of political power, which they considered to be very threatening, and which they also resented in a sense that narcissists resent those who've had privileges that they haven't had. So I was viewed as somebody who had unfair privileges, and I had to be brought down quite a few pegs and taught my lessons. That was how I experienced modernity. That's how it was displayed to me, made manifest to me as a new world order that viewed me as a threat and as something to be envied at the same time. So I began my philosophizing in the same way that Nietzsche did, in an attempt to give myself new coordinates in life so that I could understand better how I was now situated in life and I wouldn't constantly feel the ground sinking beneath me, as I found that none of my previous expectations or suppositions about reality had any substance anymore. And I began asking questions very aggressively in some instances, because I had to break through and find out what was true and what wasn't. One of the significant points was that I was also the victim of some considerable gaslighting, because people had made the assumption that I had been living kind of like the life of royalty, waited on hand and foot and sipping martinis near the pool as they were brought to me by black servants and being haughty and mighty. And that was very far from the truth, but I didn't know that they had that image of me in their minds, and they didn't tell me, they just suggested it and treated it as if it were true. So I had no idea of what stories had been told about people of my ilk, or why the negative responses were directed at me. So I had to deal with a lot of very, very confusing circumstances and considerable hostility. And that's why philosophy became core to my being. It was a manner of seeking wisdom and truth, and above all, trying to get rid of what was false in my own mind and in the coordinates and the moral system I had been exposed to in the modern context I had entered.